As you saw already, this cheap-ass Benzu Shiner scooter starts after many kicks, but it shuts off right away and it repeats doing it. So what do you think? What can it be? To me it feels like there's no or not enough fuel coming. So let's check on the fuel lines, and maybe this one has a membrane fuel switch, if that's the right name. Maybe that membrane is not working anymore. But check this. This brake fluid gauge is like, it's coming apart. I can stick a screwdriver through it. I don't know about you, but if I would make a brake caliper or brake system, I probably would use a brake fluid resistant gauge or plastic. No? Let's try to get fuel in the carburetor without any turnaround. The easiest way to check if fuel gets to the carburetor is to see if the carburetor bowl where the float sits inside is filled with fuel. And here, because you can't reach it, they made it, they attached a hose that ends right here. And this is the screw to empty the carburetor bowl, seems like. So the easiest way for me now is to check if fuel will come out of here. Yes, at least a little bit. But it looks really dark. Not a fresh fuel I filled in. But at least some comes out of there. What we can check as well is, this here is the fuel tank. And it's attached to a hose right here. There's no, like, the fuel switch or anything, no membrane switch, nothing. And maybe it's just this fuel filter that's clogged and don't let any fuel through. Maybe you see that it's filled with fuel, but maybe nothing goes through. This looks good to me. So we'll let out all the old fuel now and see what's going on. Okay, it jumps, but there's definitely a problem with the idling. But before we go ahead, I want to address that Kickstarter problem, and to fix it, we loosen this cover. Yeah. See a lot of rubber dirt inside from the belt. Tension is good. This one sounds good. But here we got the Kickstarter mechanism, and with cleaning and some grease, this will go easy again. Maybe the air filter is the problem, so we're gonna check. I think we gotta remove this cover right here. With all screws out, should be able to lift it up. Yes. Yeah, but this was not a problem. Looks pretty good. I'm gonna put it in like that. Just reassemble everything as it was. Like every step backwards. This Varimatic cover is roughly cleaned, and after putting some grease on the moving contact areas here, Kickstarter should go easy again. Okay, we better take this one out. For that we move the Kickstarter a little bit and turn and pull it out. That easy. See, some grease is on this one already, but we'll use the new grease on it. Clean this area a little bit. Ah, here you see this one is broken a bit, but maybe if we put it in another position than it was, this has no effect at all. Maybe we remove this circlip kind of thing. Put the grease on it, and we clean this groove as well. Don't lose this washer. Put this one on again, And don't use much grease here, because the rubber from the rubber belt will get stuck to the grease everywhere there's grease, so yeah, it's better not to use much here. Put some grease down here as well, and on this kind of half gear we got. Now we can put it in again. And see that it doesn't work. Okay, this is a stopping point. So we gotta move it like that. And now put it in. And now I wanna make sure that the destroyed part is not like actual activating moving part here. I'm a bit worried about this cable goes through here and here it ends. See that? But there's no cable or anything on the other side. I thought that I ripped it off, but there's nothing on the other side. So what is this for? I really don't know. Now this one is finished and we can mount it back on. Let's see if this is repaired. Yep, definitely good now. Not as good as it runs, but definitely not as it's supposed to. And the carburetor is really deep in there, so I think the only chance to get to it is through this big hole. Or we make a big hole here. Ah, there it is. Let's remove it. You know what? I just found a fuel valve, and as I was guessing, this is the membrane style of valve. So before we take the carb out, I will just pass this one and see if this one was the reason. There should no fuel be coming out right now when the scooter's not running. That's strange. Usually these kind of valves don't let any fuel through when this bike or motor is not running. But here fuel comes out all the time. That's no problem for me now, because I thought that there's no fuel or not enough fuel coming. So I think the carburetor is still the problem, so we take it out. Here we got it. Start with the electric choke. Remove this cover. Now we need to get to the needle and stuff. And this is a membrane style carburetor. And these kinds of, we check this one. Cracks or anything, but it looks good. Needle fell out. Needle looks clean, no scratches. And now remove the float board. What we want to look for is clogged up. Like jets or anything. This one is a fuel pump. It seems to work. Yeah, this is the, it's not the main jet, it's the like idling jet. Yeah, that's the right name, I think. And it's not clogged completely, but a little bit. So we're gonna clean that. But we found a problem actually, that's good. This one is the main jet. One is free. So I think we found the problem. It's the idling jet. I've got experience with cleaning these kind of jets with the wire brush, because these wires are really thin and the holes inside are really thin as well. but these wires usually fit through. So this one should go through if the jet is okay. Now it's not going through. We're gonna work it all the way through and then it should be good. Yeah. See? Goes through from both sides usually. Yes. I think cleaning the idling jet will make the scooter run again, so that's why we're just gonna put everything back together and see if it runs. That the needle fits into the main jet thing and position this one and mount the cover. There's no mounting, direction for the cover. Just put it on as you like it and mount the screws. Last part is this one, the electric choke. And put the cover on. Carburetor done. Let's see if the problem is fixed. Let's call it perfect. The engine is heated up. Now let's change the oil. We'll drain the oil here. Yeah, okay, I just saw that the drain bolt actually sits on the other side here, but it doesn't matter. I opened up both of them to get all the oil out. Let's get that screw back. Oil screen. Spring I got already. But the cap is still missing. Here we go. Because I don't know how much oil needs to be filled in, we will measure how much came out and then we have a number to start with when filling in. Cool. So it's about 700 milliliters. Drain bolt goes back in. Okay. And 650 cc fresh oil go in. Yeah, maybe with the funnel. This is such a dumb place for the oil filler. Why would you do that? Ah. Now we'll let run and then check. Perfect, it's in the middle. That's good.
I hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe to see how we make it faster in the next part.